Deep down in my heart, still right there from a big broken heart. And baby, I tried, but I couldn't let you go. You were tied to me like an anchor to my soul. All I wanna know.
They are back and they have become, I want to say, stars now. I had that prediction. Autumn Hill, Terea, Mike. We were sitting in the little park theater, right, chatting, and I had, you know, mentioned, dropped some names, and I said, you know, you guys are going to be good. And I was right, wasn't I?
Thank you. I totally remember that interview. I was so nervous.
And the theater setting was great.
Yes.
Yeah.
All right, so a little hit that you've had, and the album, and the videos, and now on tour with Kira Isabella.
Yeah.
Does it get much better? And first of all, congratulations, you know, nominations for Best Duo for Canadian Country Music Awards and the Junos.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Has this gone to your heads?
Oh my gosh, I don't think it's actually sunk into our heads yet. It's, honestly, it's a dream come true, and it's such an honor to be just included in such an incredible, monumental day for, you know, music, Canadian country music, and even just Canadian music with the Junos. It was absolutely surreal.
Was there any point along the way, Mike, that maybe you thought, yeah, me and Terea can do this, Autumn Hill will be hopefully number one?
Wow. Well, we knew, I mean, the very first day we met, we wrote Favorite Mistake. And we knew right then and there that, like, the sound that we were making and the songs that we were writing, we thought were really special. You can't set expectations like that. You know, you can just write the best that you can and hope for it. And it has just been a roller coaster, an amazing 2 years, and we're just so grateful to be here. It's amazing.
Well, and how does it feel when people say, you know, that your hit single, you know, it really spoke to our relationship, and, you know, it helped us, or it brought us together, or it split us apart, and it was crazy, and it was so neat to hear that song on the radio and say, I know you guys.
That's honestly one of the best parts. We just to be able to connect with your fans on such a human level makes you feel like your music actually matters. We had a really cool experience in Fredericton this year, and a couple came up to us after the show and told us that Anything at All had brought them back together, and she was wearing a shirt with a giant anchor on it. And he actually lifted his shirt up, and he had a tattoo of an anchor with the lyrics to Anything at All actually on his back, and it was just... It's amazing. Like that, we've never experienced anything like that before, and it's just so cool.
Okay, so now we're forging ahead.
Okay.
New music.
Yes.
So does the sound stay the same, Mike, or do you change it up?
We've been working really hard on the new record. We've been writing intensely, and we're so excited about it. There definitely is that signature harmonies, Autumn Hill sound, but we wanted to make an album that had a bit more focus on energy and up-tempo and make it a really fun record. And actually, we're so excited about the tour now because half the set is all brand new material. We've never played, so we're just road testing the songs right now. And the fans have been so supportive, so amazing. They're already tweeting their favorite parts and they're singing along by the second chorus. We're just so excited to get this one out.
Well, and that's so amazing now with social media, because it can be kind of scary, can't it? I mean, singing this song for the first time, hey, we're going to sing this song for you. Don't know, but...
For sure. I mean, just keeping up with the song, remembering all the lyrics is tough, but they've been amazing. Like, they've really been cheering for these songs just as much as the singles, and that's all you can ask for as an artist, just to have your songs received so well and just connecting with your amazing fans.
And now being on tour with Kira, I mean, Kira, again, too, is now becoming an established country star herself. And she's young, too, like you guys. So do you share moments together, too, on tour?
Well, actually, it's funny you say share, because we are sharing a band. Yeah, Toronto has such a small music scene that actually a lot of the guys we've been playing with have played in various versions of our band. Yeah. And when we hooked up with Kira, you know, she had all of them together, this amazing band already, and she was so gracious to allow, you know, all of us to sort of use the same band. And it's literally like a small family just traveling across the country playing music. It's amazing.
Well, that's the beauty of the country scene, I think, too. And they've said, too, you've successfully crossed it over to pop. But, I mean, I think country, too, is still true to your hearts.
Oh, absolutely. Growing up in Calgary, I listen to country music just as much as every other genre. I never really made the distinction between the two, but the country community is so incredibly friendly, and they've embraced us in such a sweet, amazing way that we're just so fortunate and really blessed to be a part of this genre.
Well, enjoy the roller coaster ride. Before we go, what is something that you've learned in the past 2 years that has really resonated with you?
Sleep a lot when you're on tour. Sleep whenever you can and as much as you can all the time.
And you?
Oh, I'm going to agree.
Oh,
literally.
Come on.
Passed out in the van.
You have to. It's unbelievable. The tour is, honestly, our favorite thing to do is get on stage and get to play in front of crowds and stuff. But, you know, by about a week in, you're just like, oh my God, I have to sleep somewhere. So sleep in vans and planes and in airports.
Cable boots. Yeah, like, we're passed out all over the place.
Well, maybe there's a couch for rent out there. Oh, well, we can hardly wait for the new album. And
thank you.
Stay true to your roots. We love you. Autumn Hill. For Backstage 30, I'm Tracy Kogan.